sales engineer again, and let's see, our next little guy that we're going to take a look at is somewhere. Where'd I put it? Aha. We're going to look at the beautiful GlenGary. The Clan GlenGary nib that I got from J&T in the UK. Look at this beautiful violin nib. Now, looking at it, you might think, hey Pat, didn't we just see one of these nibs? We did. And this is another violin nib called the Favorite 145 from M. Myers and Sons. And I think if I was able to put them against paper for you, like this, you could see that even the nib holes are the same. Come on, little camera. Come on. I wonder if I even have this silly focus on. Anyway, there we go. Now it is. So now you can see, hopefully, that the holes for the nibs are almost identical, yet two different companies. Okay? Now, we did this one. This is the Favorites 145. And the significant thing about this was that it had an actual pill for the nib. Can you see it at the very, very tip? Right there is a little bit of a pill, and that made it a rather large, rather a medium kind of a writer. Okay, so we did that one before, and we're going to do this guy, but this one has a really interesting shape by comparison. Take a look at this. Look at the end. It's actually pushed down and then back up. See that? It's got the brush along the tip, the brushed part that's going to hold the ink really well. But look at that curve at the end. I'm really hoping this is going to be a writer, not a drawer. And there's the split at the side of the nib to allow it to flex. And we had exactly the same thing on the 145. This one, however, is made by C. Brandauer. That's B-R-A-N-D-A-U-R. C. Brandauer. And it is called the Clan GlenGary. G-L-E-N-G-A-R-R-Y. So if you're looking for this one, J&T has this. And among other places. I mean, I just got a bunch of stuff from them, so the shipping was great. They're at J&T and Calligraphy. So J&T's Art and Calligraphy.co.uk. Let's take a look at this guy. Well, you can get an idea for how big it is when it was in my hand, right? So as I lay it up against the ruler here, you can see, you know, an inch and three quarter. Pretty good size. Now, I'm not going to fool myself into thinking that this is solid gold. That'd be nice. But I paid £1.21. I hope that's the right way to say it. £1.21 for this little guy. So I've got a feeling gold is, more expensive than that. Let's go ahead, since this is brand new, let's go ahead and throw it in the holder. Oh my goodness, this guy really is hard to put in. Oh my, wow. Almost wish I'd used a rag or something. Usually not that hard. I can adjust this by pushing. That's the nice thing about these nibs. I can go ahead and squeeze that a little bit with a pair of pliers and she'll go in and out no problem. But as we know, taking my little helper from not walking across the keyboard, which automatically for some reason stops everything, One of the things I wanted to show you was this little thing. I know it's up kind of close and everything. This is some sort of hobby knick-knack thing that you get at Walmart. And each one of these little guys, I mean, they're relatively sturdy, opens up, and you can put your little nibs in there. They fit really, really well, and see which ones are which. I imagine you could draw on this with a Sharpie or something and see which ones they are. Maybe some people aren't like me. Maybe, you know, when you get into something, you're like, oh, you know, I don't know if I'm really going to like it or not. I don't know if I should really, you know, I'm going to get one nib. You know, they're only a dollar. So maybe that's how some people are. The zebra, I've got a whole holder here that they ship a bunch of 10 with. So you get this nice little plastic thing. It doesn't feel like it's really going to stay closed. And they ship them to you like this. It says zebra across it. Okay? But I like this idea. Now, let's go ahead back to... I just want to show you that. Let's go back to getting this guy burned in. Now, I'm doing this, just if you haven't heard any of the other videos, I'm doing this because all of these come with a protective coating to keep them from rusting as they sit new on shelf, new on stock, whatever, waiting for one of us to buy them. So we have to burn that off. Usually it's a very, very thin coat of wax. Otherwise, I think the steel ones would just sit there and rust after a while. So let's go ahead and do that. And I want you to take a very close look at how even the coloring is here, because it's not going to look like that when we're done. So people say a couple seconds, people do whatever. Well, I'm going to show you exactly how long I do it. All mine I do, when I do these for you, I do them right in front of you. Okay? So there we go. I can smell a little bit of almost like a rubber kind of a burn. And also, be very careful. When you're doing this, use a nib holder that's wooden, that has a nice metal, spring mechanism here. Don't use one like this that has rubber and plastic, okay? This is the T40, the Tashikawa T40. I love this thing. Be very careful. Always use one that is got metal, because otherwise, right, that amount of heat is going to mess with it and make it melt that plant. And once, of course, it's melted, that's it, right? So let's see how well the ink will take to this guy. Oh, wow. I can already tell you, it's almost as stiff as the 145 was, the Myers, almost. And that tip at the end, that little tip up, is really, really noticeable. Maybe a dark surface will help you see it better. Okay. Maybe it'll make it far worse. Hey, look, there's the camera. Okay, that actually makes it, well, I don't know, it's kind of hard to focus it. Maybe easy. Now look at that. What's really interesting is that this kept its shine, the patina, and also, I hope I can show this to you, there's some roughness right here at the end, in between the nib hole and the very, very end. And this is the top of the nib. Come on, Microsoft. There's the top of the nib. So, there you go. You don't want to look at my ugly mug, right? So, let's see if this guy is a smoother writer. Well, I'm not even going to put any pressure, any ink on it, but I can already tell you, it takes a little bit of flex to get that nib to open up. Can you see it? I can't do a zoom here. That's why I'm doing this at high resolution. But, oh wow, it really is nice. This has the feel of, without any ink in it whatsoever, it has the feel of a nib in a fountain pen. Already so smooth, you know, it's not a scratchy feel. So let's see. Well, I'd say it's taken the ink pretty well. Look at that. Perfect. If your nib is properly burned in, as we say, right, you're gonna see it cover with the ink perfectly. There won't be any spots that are gappy. And the reason, of course, is because the reason this does this, why that covering is there, is because it's there to protect the nib, just like wax on your car. So let's go ahead and let's see how it feels in writing. Oh, wow. Well, this is a big fat writer. Look at that. This is like writing with a big magic marker. Holy cow, I didn't expect it to be this big. I will tell you though, I've done writing. I've gotten rid of some ink on this paper and it is still going. Oh, there we go. We're just now out. This is not gonna be, this is almost, I almost have to be really careful not to put a lot of ink in because look what happened when I first started, right? So, let's see, where can I go? So you can still see what's going on. Let me try to move things around a little bit. There we go. So you can still see something. So, it feels really nice in your hand, I will tell you that. As far as like filling things in, I'm filling them in like I have a magic marker. But doing that took all of the dip that I had. And maybe it wasn't a very, very big dip. I also took a lot off of it by stroking the outer rim of this ink reservoir to see how much of it I could get off of it, hoping that it wouldn't start like this, right? I'm trying to see if I can get it to start a little bit more consistently. So, and that's it. It is. So once I get a little bit of that ink off of the tip, then it tends to give me a little bit more consistent of a start. We're not having the big blotchy issue. This was a mistake earlier. This is not a calligraphy nib. But boy, as one that you can draw with, this is actually really, really easy to draw with. Very, very easy. The ink wants to come out, and it's definitely it's definitely for drawing where you're gonna use a lot of ink, you're going to be dipping frequently. This isn't one that I could write a lot with because look how thick this is. It's drawing at almost a 16th of an inch across. But the flow is just perfect. I mean, if you're going to do some heavy shading and whatnot, this is the guy for you. Really do like this, actually. If you've got a lot of ink to get rid of, this is the guy. And unfortunately, what I found when trying to buy these nibs is that none of them really come with any sizing or anything. They won't tell you, are they a fine, an extra fine. In the fountain pen world, it's very specific. Is it a left oblique? Is it a 1.1 millimeter? What is it? So here we have completely different standards for, in fact, no standards for whatever the nibs are going to be. So I almost find that it's easier to not even have any kind of a standard and just let the nib go ahead and, you know, be whatever it's going to be. I mean, if you're not going to tell us how thick the line is and such, then just, you know, don't do anything. Don't tell us anything. But this is a really great nib for the collection. It's got that really crazy curl to the bottom of it. If I could draw that for you, it looks kind of like this and that. That's the part I'm talking about. So here's your violin hole up here. It's this part right here that makes this guy a real thick drawer. Thick. And the only time I think you ever want to write thick is when you're signing, right? So, you know, you've got your big signature, and, you know, it doesn't even let me do a full full big signature with you know, flourishes here, because it's takes too much ink. But there you go. This is our Clan GlenGary, which, again, it doesn't really tell you anything about how big it is, and that's in by C. Brandauer, and just again so you can know who that is, B. R. A. N. D. A. E. U. R. Did I get that right? A. U. E. R. A. U. E. R. And this is definitely a filling in kind of shading kind of nib. Nice and thick. Oops, you can't see the name, can you? There you go. Oh, it's too far back. Oh, there we go. Brandauer. This is fun. It's a fun nib to play with. But, I gotta end the video. But, what a fun video. A fun nib to play with. It's not your everyday writer. It's not comparable to any type of fountain pen nib, because it's just way too broad. I don't even think the broadest of fountain pen nibs can put out as much as this guy does. And the only thing about this is, and it actually has a split to the nib, is if you need more, the only problem with this is you can't go thin. So it's like, once you decided that you're going to go with this guy, it's got to be thick. There's no thin to thick. And that's it for the Brandauer Clan GlenGary. It's a fun little nib. For a buck, not bad. Thanks.